大家好, welcome back to Edupedia World Videos. We are now at lesson 20, where we'll speak about a topic on conversation about posting a letter. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to post a letter in Chinese, okay? I know some of you may think that posting a letter should be easy because it's just a matter of placing the stamp on the top right corner. But in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to send an international letter. So it is not as easy as that because you still need to weigh how heavy the letter is before you can actually send an international letter by email or even by registered post. Okay, let's get started. So this conversation involves Emma wanting to post a letter. In Mandarin, the title is 艾玛想要寄信. Emma first made it clear like what she wants. So she says, I want to post two letters.
艾玛说,我要寄两封信.
And Harry answers, and he's the one working in the post office. He asks, where do you like to post them?
Harry 问, 往哪儿寄?
And Emma answers Harry's question. She says, one to Guangzhou, and the other to the United States.
艾玛说, 一封寄到广州, 一封寄到美国.
Harry asks again, because it involves international postage. So he asks, are they ordinary letters or registered ones?
Harry 问, 是平信还是挂号信?
So I will pause the conversation now and we'll continue in the next lesson. We have quite a few new words here, so let's look at them sentence by sentence. So first of all, I just want to look at the title again so you know how to write the individual words in it. The title is Emma wants to post a letter.
艾玛想要寄信.
So the first word is I. I, it doesn't really have a meaning there, but sometimes it is used in a plant. It's a plant's name. This is the pinyin I, and the radical is what's on top there. So the arrangement is vertical because you have top and bottom component. Let's look at how to write I.
二三四五.
Five strokes for this word, I. Okay, and you have learned ma, as in Mali, Mary. Okay, so they both share the same word. So,
艾玛 is Emma.
想要, you have learned already. It means once. And the next word, 寄, is sent or post. Okay, so it is the action of sending or posting a letter or a parcel. Okay, this is the pinyin 寄, and the radical is what's on top there. So the arrangement is vertical because you have top, middle, and bottom component. Let's look at how to write 寄.
一二三四五六七八九十十一.
11 strokes for this word 寄. The last new word of this slide is 信. 信 means letter, and in some other contexts, it has an entirely different meaning, which means belief or faith. Okay, in that case, it is a verb rather than a noun in this context. This is the pinyin 信, and the radical is what's on the left there. The arrangement is horizontal because again,
You have left and right components. Let's look at how to write C. Yi, er, san, si, wu, liu, qi, ba, jiu. 9 strokes for this word, 姓. So to say 爱吗想要即兴 should be easy for you, because in direct translation it's just Emma wants post letter. The grammar structure is like subject, verb, 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 and finally an object. We have covered this kind of grammar structure quite extensively, so there should be no problem for you. Let's go to the next slide. So Emma walks into a post office. So she's stating what her aim is. She says, I want to post 2 letters. 我要寄两封信. Let's look at the new word here. The only new word is 封. 封 is serving as a quantifier for letters. Or if it's not a quantifier, it is used in envelopes or to seal something. Okay, so that's the meaning of feng in many different contexts. But in this context, it is a quantifier for letters. Okay, this is the pinyin feng, and the radical is what's on the right there. The arrangement is horizontal because you have left and right components. Let's look at how to write feng. 一二三四五六七八九. 9 strokes for this word, 风. Let's look at how to decipher this sentence. So 我要寄, it means I want to post, and 两封信 should be easy enough for you, as you have encountered many quantifiers and many objects in the past. So 两封信 is just to say 2 letters. Okay, so the whole sentence is again very easy. 我要寄两封信 is I want to post 2 letters, and in proper English it's 我要寄两封信. Okay, there should be no problem with this. Let's look at the next slide and see how the officer in the post office responds to her purpose of being in the post office. So the officer is Harry. So Harry asks, where do you like to post them? 哈利问, 往哪儿寄? Okay, so the first word is ha. So ha is actually the sound of laughing. So when you hear someone laughing like ha ha ha, in Mandarin you can imagine that he is using this word. So this is the pinyin ha, and the radical is what's on the left there. So the arrangement is horizontal because you have left and right component. Let's look at how to write ha. 一二三四五六七八九. 9 strokes for this word, ha. Okay, so you have learned the word li as in 便利, okay, which means convenient. But in this context, it is just to use as in Harry, just to borrow the sound. Now you know Harry in Mandarin, it is ha li. And the next new word is wang. Wang is 2, but it is more of a directional 2. This is the pinyin wang, and the radical is this one, what's on the left there. So the arrangement is again horizontal, as you have left and right component here. Let's look at how to write 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 strokes for this word, 王. So, 王哪儿记? In direct translation, it's to where post. It may sound like too simple to you, but in Mandarin or in Chinese, sometimes we leave out the subject. Sometimes it's also polite to not include the subject, so it doesn't sound that imperative, but it is to ask like, what do we have to do? So 王 is to, and 哪儿 is where. So 往哪儿 is to say to where. It sounds like you are asking the driver, where should we go? That also makes sense if you want to use in that context. Okay, 记, as we have covered before, it means post. So we are omitting the subject here. So if you really want to insert a subject, you can insert it in front, 你往哪儿记? Or if you want to make it sound more like English, you can just insert it between 往哪儿 and 记, to sound like to where you are posting this. And of course, if you want to say that properly in Mandarin, it is 你往哪儿记? And then, because 往哪儿 is like a description to the place you want to post, so that's why 往哪儿 is placed in front of the word 记. It looks intuitive to you as an English speaker. In English, sometimes you say you post to where, but in Mandarin it's to where post, okay? Because to where is the description of the verb post. It is describing where to post it, the location of the letter that's going to. So that's why we are using 往哪儿记, okay? Instead of 记往哪儿. So Emma answers, she says, 往to广州, 一封寄到广州. So there are two new words here. The first one is 广. 广, it means broad. Okay? And this is the pinyin 广. And the radical is itself, so the arrangement is simple. Let's look at how to write 广. 一二三. Okay, three strokes for this word, 广. The next one is 州. So 州 means state, as in the states in the country. For example, the United States has many states, so those states we refer it to as 州. For example, California we call 加州. Okay, the 州, we are using the same 州 over there. Okay, it's not the kind of state as in gaseous state or solid state, okay, or even in the usage as in statement. Okay, so this state, it is just to use in geographical state. Okay, this is the pinyin 州, and the radical is this one. The arrangement is simple. Let's look at how to write 州. 一二三四五六. Okay, so you can imagine that's like a river separating the two states, so that's how we got this word state from. To say 一封寄到广州 is to say a letter to be posted to 广州, to arrive in 广州. So 一封 means the letter, but we refer to it with the number and the quantifier. Okay, we don't need to specify the object again. And then to say 寄到 is to say that the letter will be sent to a place, which is Guangzhou. Guangzhou is Canton, so it is where Cantonese is spoken. It is a big city in China. Okay, so that's how we say one of the letter will be sent to Guangzhou, just to say 一封寄到广州. So Emma hasn't finished yet, and she states further, the other to the United States, 一封寄到美国. Okay, so it's the same thing, just say one letter to be sent to the United States. Okay, you have learned all the words here. 一封 is again the same number and quantifier for letter, and then 寄到 is to post to, and then 美国, as you have learned before, it is United States. So Xiaoli got that the letter is an international letter, so he needs to make sure the requirement of the letters. Okay, so he asks, are they ordinary letters or registered ones? 是平信还是挂号信? Okay, so the first new word here is 平. 平 means ordinary or flat. So you can imagine that things, when they are flat, it's quite ordinary, nothing exciting happening, so it's ordinary. Okay, this is the pinyin, ping, and the rather goes this one. The arrangement is simple. Let's look at how to write ping. 一二三四五, five strokes for this word, ping. The next word is 挂. 挂 is to hang something. So let's say you're hanging a towel. You use this word here, 挂. Okay, this is the pinyin 挂, and the radical is what's on the left there. So the arrangement is horizontal because you have left and right components. Let's look at how to write 挂. 一二三四五六七八九. Nine strokes for this word, 挂. Let's look at the question here. So, 小李 asks, 是平信还是挂号信? So, indirect translation is ordinary letters or hanging numbers letters. Okay, it doesn't make sense to you, but I'll explain it. So, 平信, 平 is just to mean ordinary. So, together with 信, 平信, it means ordinary letters. And then the next word is 还是. Okay, 还是, sometimes it means still is, because you have learned that 还, it means still, but it can also use as. And 挂号信. Okay, so you have learned that 号 is number, so 挂号 is like to hang number to a letter, which means that the letter has a number assigned to it, which is the registered letter. Okay, so 挂号信 is how we would say registered letters. Okay, so in the end, when Xiaoli asks 是平信还是挂号信, it's just asking, is it ordinary letter or registered one? Okay, so that's how you can ask all questions in that yes or no question. Okay, so in the end, Emma just have to make the choice whether it's say 是平信 or 是挂号信. So Xiaoli has presented all the choices over there, just using is ordinary letter or is registered once. We pause the conversation now because we have learned quite a few new words here. So here are all the Chinese words that you have learned. So you have learned the names such as Emma, Harry, and Guangzhou, the name of place. And also some other things like letter and its quantifier, how to say post, and to, another way of saying to. And then the other words like ordinary slash flat, because they share the same word, and also hang. Okay, and of course you have learned how to say ordinary letter or registered letters. Okay, so in the next lesson, we're gonna go through what Emma's answer is, and also more vocabulary when you are posting a letter. Okay, so I'll see you in the next video. Thanks again for watching. 谢谢，再见.